Okay. How are you guys doing today? It's your man, it's Zombie Man, coming at you with a team communication video. We're going to start a series. It's going to be a quick, kind of short series, shorter than the rest, than the other two. And we're going to go over team communication, early game, mid game, and late game. So let's hop right into it. Team communication, what do we want to do for early game callouts? First off, everyone wants to ping their LZ. Our jump master should have a designated ping to where he's going to land. And then as a team, we can decide what we want to do. We can expand and capture. I'll draw them out right here. Expand and capture, what does that look like, right? Let's say our jump master pings. So our jump master pings here. Let's say this is a building. We can either land on his bottom floor. Well, no, not. Expand and capture. Yeah, expand and capture. We just want to expand around him, right? Let's say we expand around him. And then we're all going to regroup at one point. This is good if you're landing alone, right? If you're landing alone, just trying to loot up quick and then get out of there. But yes, expand and capture. Capture and expand. What is capture and expand? This is good if we're landing with multiple teams around us. You know, if there's more than five teams, then, you know, you're landing in a kill zone, good luck. At that point, I would suggest if you're landing with more than five squads to land on the perimeter of that kill zone, right? Loot the small amount of buildings that you can and then approach your kill zone properly. Instead of landing right in the middle of kill zone and then just leaving it to RNG and team positioning. But capture and expand. What do I mean by this? We can all land in the same building and then we're just going to expand. Right? Or maybe even that way. Sweeping. This is probably the most common LZ that you'll see, right? We're all gonna land kind of on a parallel line to each other. And then we're gonna sweep through our LZ accordingly. All going at the same pace, right? If this dude falls behind or something, we would kind of want to post up for a second, you know, find high ground, just scope out the area, make, you know, get information on squads, and just wait, continue moving parallel with each other. But yeah, also, another thing that you want to do in early game is you don't want to pass up any of the good loot. And what I mean by that is knowing how to loot quickly. Don't pass up your Mozambique. Do not pass up your P2020. For two reasons. One, excuse me, they can carry attachments, right? You can carry a bolt. You can carry a mag. You can carry a sight with them. Even though they're not good weapons, they're going to be, you know, they're just extra inventory space. Also, you know, before you land, if you have a preferred loadout that you know how to build towards, go just call that out to your team. You know, 301 PK. Me personally, that's what I use the majority of the time, is the 301 PK. Because, you know, once late game comes around, once you get into those more close quarters combat fights, you know, you're going to be able to pick up that R99. And for me personally, a 301, I'm much more consistent with one-clipping people with a 301 at, you know, 50 meters out. An R99, you know, it's definitely got that damage output, but your level of consistency that you'll be able to one-clip people is going to be more, it's going to be more practical with the 301 early game. And attachments, right? Let's say, you know, we want to call out the important attachments for, you know, when you get that level 2 mag on a light weapon, you know, you're really able to start to one-clip people. Or even a you know, on heavy weapons, you know, the percent ratio that of extra ammunition you get is really good. So call that out. Get those pings out. Even if you're carrying a Mozambique, you know, if you get that Mozambique, instantly ping hammer point, right? Instantly ping that hammer point. It turns that tier one weapon into a tier four. Very disgusting. Very disgusting weapon. But yeah, really quick video on team communication for early game. Not too much you want to talk about for early game. You know, if you're going to be landing with another squad that's more mid-game communication, we'll find that in the mid-game. And, yeah. But for early game, really want to just be talking about your early rotation. For the most part, you know, you want to be talking about your rotation, right? It's going to be pretty slow in the early game. So you definitely want to be talking about, you know, what our rotation is going to look like, whether we want to go through a hot zone to try and pick up those kills, or if we want to loop around somewhere just to get more ring priority. But yeah, it's your man, Zombie Man. I'm out. Peace.